reviewing the top 10 best-selling men's fragrances of 2024. These best-selling men's fragrances are based off the two biggest USA retailers, Macy's and Ulta, and I sorted their fragrances by best-selling, starting off with Valentino Born in Roma Intense. Am I surprised that this is the best-selling Valentino? A little bit, because Green Extravaganza is the newest one, but I believe this is the best-selling because, in my opinion, it is the most mass-appealing and easy-to-like Valentino fragrance. It's bubblegum sweet, it's a little bit fresh, it has strong performance, but it's unique, but it's also simple enough where you can get any average Joe off the street to take a whiff of this stuff, and there's a 99% chance that they'll probably love it. The first time that I wore this fragrance, I just bought it and I decided to wear it that night. I was on the way to a dinner, I was driving myself there, and I kept getting whiffs of myself, and since I was kind of focused on driving, just subconsciously in my brain, I was like, what the hell smells so good? And the whiffs were coming every 5-10 minutes, and then I was like, Finn, you're being an absolute idiot. It is coming from the fragrance that you just sprayed about an hour ago. This stuff just has that super addictive, you know, you just want to keep smelling type of quality to it. I think this definitely deserves to be in the best-selling men's fragrances of 2024. In terms of a rating, I would give this an 8.5 out of 10. Up next, we have YSLY Myself EDP. This was actually at the top of both Macy's and Ulta's best-selling list, and apparently I've just been living under a rock for the past 6 months because I didn't even know this fragrance was popular until around 2 weeks ago when I walked into my local fragrance department store, and out of curiosity, I asked the sales lady, you know, what is your best-selling fragrance at the moment? Without even hesitation, she said, it's been YSLY EDP for months now, and I literally looked at her like, you're not serious, right? Like, did you mean to say Jean-Paul Gaultier, Le Male Elixir, Dior Sauvage 1 million? Nope. YSLY Myself is selling like crazy right now, so I had to pick it up, and I could honestly totally see why. It is just such a mass appealing and easy to like formula. It's fresh, it's a tiny bit spicy, it's got the YSLY DNA, it smells fairly similar to the EDP, but it's got its own kind of little twist on it. Just like Valentino Born in Roma Intense, it's addictive, it's gonna pull compliments. I'm really looking forward to keep wearing this one more. If you want a unique, complex, difficult fragrance, this is not the one to get. Just like most of the ones on this list, to be honest, because they are popular, because they're easy to like. But if you want guaranteed compliments, you want a fragrance that you know you can spray on, and it basically guarantees that you'll be the best smelling guy no matter where you go, YSLY Myself EDP is a great option. There's also a YSLY Myself Parfum now, which I have not tried, but I've heard that one is also really good. In terms of rating, I'm gonna give this one an 8 out of 10. Next up on the popularity list was one that I honestly didn't expect to see, and that is Dior Homme Intense, because I know this fragrance is very popular and very highly regarded in the fragrance community, but in terms of the general public's opinion, I didn't realize this thing sold so well. But am I surprised? Not really. This is honestly a masterpiece fragrance. It is probably the most challenging fragrance on this list, but I think if you're getting more into fragrances, your nose is developing, and you particularly like the smell of iris, you will love Dior Homme Intense. A lot of people say it smells very powdery, almost kind of lipsticky. I don't know what lipstick smells like, to be 100% honest with you guys, but I just think this thing smells gorgeous. It is so mature, elegant, sophisticated. If I, you know, had a suit and tie event and I just wanted to smell up the standard, you know, I want to smell richer than I actually was, Dior Homme Intense is one that I would definitely reach for. In terms of an overall rating, I understand a lot of people have this as their best designer fragrance ever created. They're one of their favorite fragrances of all time. I don't quite see it as that good. I do have a lot of fragrances that I'll put above it, but I do think that objectively it is a masterpiece fragrance. I'm gonna give this one a 9 out of 10. In at the number 4 spot is another Dior fragrance. This one is Dior Sauvage EDP. However, I do think on the list it was Dior Sauvage EDT. However, if we're gonna be completely honest with ourselves here, every single Sauvage, even the new Sauvage that sprays out literal milk on your skin because it's water-based, will probably sell well because it's Dior, because of Johnny Depp, because of the mass-appealing formula. Dior Sauvage is a timeless classic. It will forever be a timeless classic. I would be surprised if in the next 30 years, there is a single year that goes by where Dior Sauvage is not going to be on a top 10, a top 20 best-selling men's fragrances list. Dior Sauvage EDP is my favorite because it is a little bit less kind of juvenile than the EDT, but it also has very strong performance. I get better performance on the EDP than any other Sauvage formulation except the Elixir. However, the Elixir is just too strong. It's got that too much licorice for me. Sauvage EDP is versatile enough. It still gets compliments, but it isn't quite as overplayed as the EDT. In terms of a rating, I would go with a nice 8.2 out of 10. To be honest, I don't reach for it very often, but I can still appreciate that is a classic, classic, timeless fragrance. In at the number 5 spot is Acqua di Gio Profondo. This one is the newest Profondo parfum. However, I still think, at least for the time being, the regular Profondo, the original Profondo, is selling the best. But Profondo Parfum is actually my favorite Acqua di Gio fragrance. I've noticed that it isn't very highly rated. I believe it has currently a 3.7 out of 5 on Fragrantica. I think it should be at least a 4, 4.1, 4.2. It is extremely marine, aquatic heavy. It's got a really nice mandarin note, but then it has patchouli in the base, which kind of adds some depth and sophistication to it. Although this is undeniably an extremely blue fragrance, if you wore this in the wintertime at a nighttime event, it has enough depth where you could easily get away with wearing this as a all year round signature scent, especially if you're an older, more traditional masculine guy. I think this fragrance would suit you perfectly. And although we just passed Father's Day, if I was gonna get my dad a fragrance for Father's Day, this would be the first one that I would go for. Surprisingly enough, although on paper this doesn't look like it would be my type of fragrance that I would wanna wear, I've been loving this, wearing it to the gym 3, 4, 5 times a week. Haven't got any compliments with it yet, but I really enjoy wearing it. I'm gonna give this an 8.5 out of 10, which I never thought I would say for an Acqua di Gio fragrance. I'm not gonna be surprised if this one picks up in popularity, the reviews start to pick up and get higher, as they often do once a fragrance has, you know, had time to marinate with the general public. I'm really loving this stuff. At the number 6 spot with our first Jean Paul Gaultier out of 2, it is Le Male Elixir. Am I surprised that this is here? No. Do I wish that it was Le Male Parfum instead of Le Male Elixir? Well, kind of. I mean, I do, because I think it's a better fragrance, but I guess it's kind of nice that Le Male Parfum is still a little bit more under the radar. I do think Le Male Parfum is better than Le Male Elixir. They're both sweet and sexy scent DNAs. This one is more of a lavender, vanilla heavy with some kind of a honeyed note combination, whereas Le Male Parfum, the one with the black bottle and the gold cap, has a powdery iris note instead of the honey and the, you know, more powerful lavender in Le Male Elixir. Although I can see why this is in the best-selling list, and I can see why it would arguably get the most amount of compliments out of any Jean Paul Gaultier fragrance, for my personal preference, it is too sweet, too loud, and too cloying. It does make me nauseous, and it often does give me a headache when I used to wear this. For that reason, I do prefer Le Male Parfum, but I can appreciate objectively that this is a solid fragrance, and I'm not surprised at all to see it on the best-selling list in 2024. In terms of a rating out of 10 that I would give this fragrance, that's kind of tricky for me, because if it was up to me, I'd give it probably a 6 out of 10, but objectively, I understand that it is a solid fragrance. When it came out at the time, it was quite innovative compared to what a lot of other designer fragrances were putting out into the market. So for that, I'm gonna give this a 7 out of 10. We've now made it to the number 7 spot, and it is another Jean Paul Gaultier fragrance. You guys really shouldn't be surprised. It is Paradise Gardens. Le Beau Le Parfum probably is one of the best selling too, but Paradise Gardens seems to have gotten a better public reaction in terms of sale and mass appeal. I freaking adore this stuff. This is my second favorite Jean Paul Gaultier fragrance, and it works all year round. Even though, you know, you can tell by the liquid, it's a green fragrance. It's obviously advertised as a very summery scent. I think it works perfectly all year round because it is so sweet and it has that oomph to it, you know? It's got the coconut, it's got that kind of tonka bean base. You could definitely use this during the winter time if you really wanted to. It is just so refreshing to spray on because it's minty, coconut, it's green. I actually am starting to love green fragrances as opposed to blue fragrances, and that's probably one of the reasons I just love this stuff so freaking much. On top of the amazing and uplifting smell, it lasts a very long time. I get 8-9 hours longevity with moderate to strong projection, especially in the first 2 hours. I just can't also get over how beautiful and gorgeous the packaging is. Although packaging, a lot of people do not give two shits about it. Personally, I think it makes the wearing experience a lot more fun when the bottle looks really, really cool. But let me know what you think in the comments. In terms of a final rating, I'm gonna go high with this one and give it an 8.8 out of 10. The only reason I would recommend you might want to steer away from this is if you prefer more natural smelling fragrances. This smells like a 7-Eleven Slurpee snow cone. It smells very artificial and very synthetic. But if you don't mind that like me, you will probably love this stuff. Coming in next is a brand new release from Versace. I don't believe this was on Ulta or Macy's site yet, but essentially this is going to be a prediction because I do think this fragrance is going to become very, very popular. My reasoning for that is one, because of the marketing and the packaging. It is called Versace Eros Energy. It is in kind of like a Red Bull energy drink looking bottle. It also smells very citrusy and fresh. And a designer fragrance releasing a citrusy fresh fragrance is always gonna, you know, really hit well with the masses. Personally, I do find this smells a little bit too close to the Creed Aventus scent profile for me to really fall in love with this fragrance. Since I bought it, I have started to like it just a little bit more. I do, however, every time I spray it, can't help thinking of super synthetic lemon cleaner. I think, although this is a very citrusy fragrance, it is too lemon heavy. It smells like freshly squeezed lemon cleaner. Not lemon, freshly squeezed lemons turned into lemon cleaner. I don't know how else to explain it. It's like a more citrusy, uplifting version of the Creed Aventus DNA, but I don't like the smell of lemons enough to really, really like this fragrance. I would say unless you are very specifically looking for the Creed Aventus DNA made more citrusy and uplifting, there's not much need to try this one. Try Versace Eros Flame instead, blood orange, spicy with the original Eros DNA. This one, unless you want another Creed Aventus kind of ripoff and copy for a very expensive price, I would stay away from Versace Eros Energy. However, there is a good chance it is going to become very, very popular and probably in 2025 be in the top 10 best-selling list. In terms of a rating, I'm going to give this a 6.8 out of 10. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm not really sorry, though, for being honest. Coming into the number 9 spot, I believe this is actually going to be my favorite fragrance on this list, edging just past Dior Homme Intense, my baby, Stronger With You Intensely. The reason this one is so popular right now is because it was rumored to be discontinued, and it was discontinued for so long, and Armani had so much pushback from the general public that they actually decided to recontinue Strong With You Intensely and Strong With You Absolutely. Bless the gods, bless the fragrance gods for us pushing back and Armani caving and bringing back this gem into the public. I own 4 bottles of this stuff. It is what blew up my fragrance journey, my career, you could say. Christmas in a bottle is what I used to call it because it does have that Christmassy, warm, spicy, ambery, toffee, vanilla smell. However, I will say, I feel like Christmas in a bottle doesn't give it credit for how versatile it can be. I have worn this in the summertime with just 2 to 3 sprays, had no complaints, have never felt that it's just too cloying of a fragrance. I think you can use this in pretty much any season except the hottest and hottest of days. I also do feel that the recontinued versions are even stronger than what they used to be. Like with this new bottle, I'm pushing 10 hours longevity with strong projection. It's an awesome smell, one of the best designer fragrances of all time. Right now, probably my favorite designer fragrance of all time. It's nothing short of a 9.5 out of 10. And finally, the number 10 spot, it is just slotted in. It is Ralph Lauren's Polo 67. I own Ralph Lauren Polo Black, Polo Red Parfum, Polo Blue Parfum, and one other one, but this one is just levels above. This is probably the best Ralph Lauren Polo release that they have ever made. They do also have some other fantastic fragrances like Ralph's Club Elixir, which I haven't tried, but I've heard that one is amazing as well. But this release honestly really, really surprised me. When I first sprayed it on, I was not expecting much from it in the store, but I ended up leaving with a bottle that very day because the opening is just so freaking surprising. It is like a burst of just citrusy freshness, but there's some depth. I don't know what note it is. It's almost like a vanillic kind of note. I don't think vanilla is a note, but especially in the dry down too, I get almost kind of a vanilla tonka bean smelling base. I think this does work best in the summer, but again, like a lot of these fragrances, you could use them year round, and I think that is one of the major factors that makes a fragrance a bestseller. The fact you can use this any day of the week, it's so easy to like. The performance is not half bad too, around 7 hours longevity. It's a fantastic release from Ralph Lauren. And you can also get it for a very affordable price. It's around 100 to 120 Aussie dollars if you get it from the right place. In terms of a final rating for the final fragrance we're talking about in this video, I'm gonna go with just a nice 8.7 out of 10. Ah, that's a bit high. Let's change that. 8.3 out of 10 for Polo 67 by Ralph Lauren. I hope you guys love this video on the 10 best-selling men's fragrances of 2024. Let me know what your favorite bestseller is of this year. Let me know what your favorite designer brand release is of this year. I'm super interested to see what you guys think. Have a great rest of your day. Like, subscribe, comment. It helps boost engagement. It costs you nothing, but it helps me out a ton. Stay safe.